So, it is time for part 4, instrumental vowels. Instrumental vowels are one of the techniques that people in neighboring disciplines like econometrics use to really get at causality if they cannot randomize things. So, let's look broadly at inspiration. We want causality about the brain. What could we possibly do? Let's look at a neighboring discipline. Let's say we want to know how smoking affects the birth weight of new babies. So imagine you want to ask if smoking causes low birth weight. Now, all kinds of factors can be relevant. For example, socioeconomic status. It could be that poor people smoke more and poor people for some other reason have babies of low birth weight, in which case it could be that there's an association between those two that has no causal meaning. We have confounding. Is it hopeless? Could we only find out if smoking lowers birth weight if we would randomly assign people to a smoking or non-smoking group? That would be very sad. So let's see. There's the idea of instrumental variables. There's tobacco taxes, and we know that tobacco taxes affect smoking here. We do know that they do not affect socioeconomic status, and that arguably in the life of an individual person, they have remarkably little effect beyond the fact that they affect smoking. And importantly also, socioeconomic status of a given person does not affect tobacco taxes in a country or in a state. And we can exploit this. So what's the idea there? We have tobacco taxes. They affect if you will smoke while pregnant, the socioeconomic status that affects both smoking while pregnant and child weight. Now, how could that possibly be? We can say that of the tobacco taxes that we have here, there's a reflection of that in the probability that someone will smoke while pregnant. Now you can say that basically the tobacco taxes define a certain part of the variance of smoking while pregnant. And now if both the rest of the confounded parts of this variable and the reflection of the tobacco taxes both influence child birth weight, then this part, the part that is made by tobacco taxes, will also have an influence on birth weight. And therefore, we can exploit that to figure out if there is a causal effect. Effectively, the prediction of the probability of smoking while pregnant that's related to tobacco taxes will be uncorrelated to people's socioeconomic status. And therefore, this component here allows us to meaningfully have something that we can use to estimate the causal effect. Technically, if you're interested in this, this is Julia Paul's Bechdel criterion here that we're dealing with. So, when we use instrumental variables, we effectively do two stages. There's one stage where we model this part here. How does do tobacco taxes affect the chances of smoking while pregnant? And then we take our estimator for this component here, and we use that in a second stage to relate that to actual birth weights of the children. By combining those two, it can be shown that you get correct causal estimates. And that's what this section is about.